So how is it going, guys? And welcome to McMood. Welcome to another episode of the 2JC FRS Swap. And today we are going to tackle something that I've been neglecting for a very long time, which is changing the famous valve stem seals. If you missed the prior episode, basically we removed the cams and everything that is attached to the front of the engine, so we do have proper access to the buckets, the springs, the retainers, the clips, and all the goodies that are behind this thing. So, before we get started, before we deep dive into how to tackle this, let me show you the parts and the tools that are actually needed for this job. Okay, so here we are. So heading into the tools, this is a tool designed by Toyo Tool, kind of famous in the internet, and it's designed to help us remove the keepers and the retainers. And once everything is done, we switch the side and it's gonna help us install the things back in place. Amazing. We'll have to remove the seals, as you can imagine, to put the new ones, and we're gonna use this plier that is also designed by these guys in Toyo Tools. And to install the seals, we're gonna use these sleeves. These are designed by Alex something. I'm gonna leave the details on the description below, but imagine this as a condom that is gonna help us protect the new seal while we install. And as you can imagine from the title, yes, we're gonna use the rope trick. And in this case, I wanna show you that the one that I'm gonna try is a 1/4 inch. So with that having said, let's head into it. Okay guys, I'm ready to get started. As you can see here, we have the four valves that are part of piston one. And I explained before, we're gonna use the rope method. We're gonna do cylinder by cylinder, and the way we will hold the valves in place, avoiding them to fall into the combustion chamber and having to remove the entire head, we don't want that, no pressure, is by using the famous rope trick. So let me show you how we're gonna do it. The first thing I need to do is I need to get the piston into the lowest position that it can possibly go. That's called VTC, and we will do this by rotating the engine. Just checking when the green thing starts going up, and I think I'm gonna hit it, and keep going down, stopped, and I think it's gonna go up. Yep, this is start to go up. So at this point I know piston one is in BTC, which is the perfect moment to start putting our rope inside the combustion chamber. A lot of road is inside. Let's see if I can compress now this thing. And let's see how much it takes to compress this. It's compressing, I start feeling resistance. Okay. Okay, cannot move it anymore. Cannot move it anymore. So at this point, everything should be loaded with rope, compressed, and the valve should be in place if I remove the keepers and the retainers and the springs and the seals. So let's give it a head and let's try with the first one. And the bucket is out. Okay guys, let me show you. We do have now access to our keepers and retainers. This is the moment where we're gonna use the Toyo tool, and these are the things that could go flying away. So we're gonna do it gently, we're gonna do it carefully. There are basically two ways of using the Toyo tool. One is giving us more, you know, push with weight of our body, and the other one is just a light hammer, like tuck, tuck, and eventually this goes out. So we're gonna give it a try and yeah, we're gonna test it. Let's see how this thing goes. Okay, give it a light touch. And let's see, I feel that this thing went out. So let's see, coming out, all of it. Okay, first one is out. Now we do have access to our valve stem seals. Let me put some light here. There we go. That thing that we see there, that's what we need to remove. That's the thing we need to remove and replace with a new one. And this thing that we see here that I'm gonna touch with my finger, this is the valve. And I press the valve and the valve is rock solid into the combustion chamber. So good. You know, the road trip apparently is working. This valve is not moving. This is the spring that came out. This was the lower part connected close to the valve. This was the upper side. Then we have this retainer thing and then the two keepers. Okay guys, now it's time to remove that seal. We're gonna do it very softly, gently, and we're gonna pull that thing out. And I include some tape as well. Main goal is to drive an extra layer of protection here. So, this out, there we go, out, let me see if I can show it. Yeah, okay, this is it, this is the thing, there we go. Yep, interesting, very interesting. Okay guys, let me show you. So the valve seal is out and there is no rubber, no nothing inside, everything was removed. Okay, so the four out of cylinder one are out. So we have two from the intake and two from the exhaust. So let me show you now what are the parts we need to change. So we have here this kind of, the first one here is first one exhaust, the second one is the second one exhaust, and the same correlation applies to the intake one. And here, let me show you, we do have the seals. First thing first, size is not the same. This one, the one from the intake, are taller. And also the ones from the intake had something in the rubber. In this case, I think it's called NGR, or no, sorry, NOK. Okay, NOK. And then nothing in the ones from the exhaust. So what are we gonna do now? Well, time to put the brand new ones. How are we gonna do this? We're gonna grab this thing here and I'm gonna show you. First thing first, we have, I brought here two with nothing written on the lip. So these two are exhaust ones. And then let me show you, out of the Toyota gasket kit, we have this small package that comes with a red tie. These are the ones that are going to be the ones for the intake. So we're gonna grab here two for the intake. And let me show you. Let's see if the camera can capture this. But ideally, I would like to show you what it says. Let's see if I can have some greater light here. Yeah, I think the focus of this GoPro is not the best. There we go. Well, I don't know if yet, I don't think you can read it. Yeah, you cannot read it, but yeah, believe me, it says N-O-K. Two from the exhaust and two for the intake. And funny enough, just let me show you one. Man. I hope the camera do some justice, but believe me, it's way larger. First, we're gonna look them a bit. Okay. Okay. Now we're gonna give it a try and see how this thing fits. Well, it does fit like a glove, so actually it's pretty nice. So I think I'm gonna use it. There we go. There we go. And all the way in. We're gonna push. There we go. And out.
Okay, so time to assembly this thing. And this is the way that I do. First, I grab the spring so I do not lose the proper direction. And I slice the spring in. Gently, gently. And I just slice it in. And I twist it just a bit to see where it plays. The second thing is assembly the retainers and the keepers. The smaller diameter goes in the inside, and the largest diameter goes in the outside. There we go. Now that I have this ready, I'm gonna place it on top of the spring. We're gonna use this side of the tool that has this thing. I'm gonna place it and gently use the weight of my body to just press it down. Let's see how this thing goes. And there we go, I heard a click. And that thing got installed. Yes. Now how we check is we use the tool in the disassembly position. And some gently push it down to see if it gives some light taps. And if everything went back, it's good and in place. If you see a keeper in here, it's because it was not properly placed. Okay, final step, put the bucket back. Let's see. Gently, there we go. Okay guys, and 24 valve seals later, the job is completed. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you learned something, and please, please let me know in the comment section below what you guys want to see in the near future in the channel, because I really want to build this as a close community, a two-way community. So with that, thank you very much. God bless you. Peace out.